We were given 5 minutes to say goodbye to a man that I was married to for 34 and a half years. He looked at me and he was scared to death. I went to the bed. I held his hand. He grabbed my arm.
Did Casey say anything to you?
He said that he loved me. And I told him that I loved him. My first and foremost thing was to save my husband's life. Every second counted.
She flew back to California, hoping to get the court to order it. This court order says you can visit him at any time. No one can stop you. And what Carrie is saying is that you chose not to see Casey anymore in the hospital.
That's not true. That is not true at all.
No one has the right to take somebody else's life.
An angry outburst outside LA Superior Court downtown. Jean Kasem, wife of radio legend Casey Kasem, accusing her stepdaughter of wrongfully trying to end the life of her father against his wishes.
Only God can take your life. And if anybody takes that life one moment before God takes you, then God help them.
This moments after a victory in the courtroom for Jean Kasem. A judge ruled today that Casey Kasem should be fed, hydrated, and medicated.
We're very happy with the court's ruling. As you know, over the course of the weekend, Carrie Kasem unilaterally decided to cease all medication for Casey Kasem, all food and all water, and put him on the equivalent of a morphine drip.
My husband's a fighter. He's an American treasure. He would have never, ever wanted this.
Hi, Jean, how are you? What's the latest with the case?
The latest is the judge decided to kill my husband today. The United States of America and the court system, this judge, the PVP attorney, Sam Ingham, Carrie Kasem, and her hired liars decided to kill my husband today.
Okay, how is he doing?
They all have blood on their hands. I haven't been able to see him since last Friday when we were told that we had a few minutes to say goodbye. I have no idea, but I know that when she picked him up last Sunday, that he was well, responsive, communicative, and there was nothing wrong with him until she picked him up. She has only had him since last, the possession of him was only since June 1st.
We submitted a sworn affidavit.
And since then, she has removed all food, all water, all medicine. We've been together for 34 and a half years. This is an example of government needs to get out of the house and out of the bedroom. And if I had the best advice for Californians that are worth anything at all or value their family, is to move out of this state. Go to Delaware, go to Wyoming, go anywhere but here, where the state is broken, the probate system is broken, and there is no justice.
On June 15th, 2014, Casey Kasem, the beloved radio icon, passed away. He was 82.
He did not die of natural causes. They planned it, and they killed him.